Every time I start working on a new computer, there's a couple of very simple settings I like to change. These are nothing groundbreaking, but they're all things that help me get more out of my computer and be more productive, so I figured I'd share these with you guys. I'm fast-forwarding through the first step here, which is setting up my widgets and desktop background. After that, I like to customize my dock. I don't like having recent or suggested applications in my dock, so I always disable that. To me, dock is where I keep my most important, frequently used applications. Anything else I can always quickly launch by using Spotlight. I like my dock clean and simple. I also like a little magnification in my dock, and instead of keeping it always visible, I like to maximize my screen space for other things, so I set the dock to automatically hide and appear. After that, I do a pass and remove all applications that I don't want in my dock. And actually, that reminds me, I need to edit my mouse preferences because right-clicking isn't enabled by default as it should be. Natural scrolling drives me absolutely nuts. I'd say there's nothing natural about it. I already had that one disabled, but that's another crucial step that you can find here. So now I'm just going to remove all the applications from my dock that I won't be using regularly, making it nice and clean. That's better. I'm not going to get too deep about which applications to install, because this is different for everyone. I already installed the basics on this one, and for me that's usually the Adobe Suite, Final Cut Pro, VLC Media Player, and iStat menus. iStat has become something I can't really live without. I love seeing all the data about my computer in the menu bar, always available by just glancing up here. The rest of my applications are pretty basic. Dropbox, some utilities for work, this depends on the user. Next up, I'm going to change a few things about my Finder window. Again, this is something I can't live without, so I have them already enabled here, but I'll change it back to the way yours is going to look when you first start using your Mac. Your default Finder window is clean and simplified like this, with nothing visible at the bottom of your window. I'm not 100% sure about this, but I want to say in the older versions of Mac OS X, there used to be a path bar and status bar visible here, which is why I still to this day like to have those visible. Maybe some of you old-timers can confirm this in the comments. Is that where I learned this from? I can't remember. The path bar will always show you where you're at in your computer's folder structure. Some of my project files go pretty deep with several subfolders, so I find it helpful to be able to check where I'm at. The status bar is nice because it shows you how many files you're currently looking at and what the free capacity of the drive where these folders are located. Small things, but I find these super helpful when juggling files and folders all day, every day. Another small thing I like to change is the Finder sidebar. Under Settings, you can choose what's displayed at the sidebar, so I'm going to add my music, photos, and movies folders here. Again, old Mac OS versions used to have these active by default, so I'm just an old soul set in my ways. And then, ladies and gentlemen, to my favorite feature, hot corners. I love hot corners. If you don't use them, shame on you. This allows you to set up specific actions for each corner of your screen, and moving your cursor to that corner will initiate the action. As you can see, my most frequently used corner is putting the display to sleep by pushing my cursor to the bottom right corner, so that's already set up. The other three I usually set up to do window application management with mission control, and maybe start a screensaver using the top right corner. These are awesome, and the easy way to put your display to sleep is awesome, especially on a desktop computer. One more thing and we're done. I'm a big Safari guy, but I hate the way it will automatically open files I download. When I download a song to use in a video, I don't want my computer to automatically open it in the music app. So I disable the option to open save files after downloading. And while we're here, I'll change the setting for how new windows and tabs open, and most importantly, set Safari to open with all the windows and tabs from my last session. And that wraps it up. There's always more that I fine-tune later, but these are the very basics I usually dial in before anything else. I would love to hear from you guys if you do the same things, or if you have other suggestions on how to make the user experience more pleasant and efficient. Shoot me comments below and let's help each other out.